a former lots of things. I'm the former governor of Mississippi. I'm a former chairman of the Republican National Committee. I'm a former director of the Office of Political Affairs for the White House. But I'm back now speaking. I do a lot of speaking around the country, mostly about politics, but some about leadership. And then I founded a lobbying firm here 20-something years ago, and I have an office there now, an office at a law firm in Jackson, Mississippi. I actually live in Yazoo City, Mississippi, and so I don't know exactly what you'd say I do for a living. Well, the job of the political director of the White House is, first of all, to try to keep the president's political friends where they feel like they're included, knowledgeable, that sort of stuff. And I'm talking about party leaders out in the countryside, big supporters, that sort of stuff. But also to make sure that not only are we working legislatively with Republican senators and House members, but we're working politically with them, that we're trying to do things that make it easier for them to get elected. We did 66 trips while I was a political director that I was responsible for, where the president went out and was campaigning for somebody else. He had been reelected. He was never going to run again. But he was very generous with his time. And so those elements kind of go together. And then finally, in the Reagan White House, politics was policy. President Reagan believed good policy is good politics. And if you'll do the right thing, it may not be popular today, but if it's good policy at the end of the day, it'll be good politics. And so we spent a lot of our time when the president would do something that wasn't necessarily popular at the start, making our people understand why he did what he did, and if they chose to teach them how to talk about it, to understand the reasons why. And that was a great lesson for me from Reagan, because like I say, Reagan thought politics and policy were inseparable, but his view of it was that way because good policy at the end of the day was always good. First of all, so many of the members don't live here, particularly on the House side, and they go home every weekend. Their families aren't here. They don't have any kind of social connection with other members of Congress. Secondly, and that is a problem. You know, people you like, it's easier to figure out how to find common ground, or you're certainly more. One of the things I didn't mention about toxicity and the lack of comity here in Washington is that the redistricting process has added to it. What we have seen in the last 40 years, and particularly the last 20 years, is the drawing of districts where a very small percentage are really competitive, that most districts are either safe for the Democrats or safe for the Republicans. And the safer Democrat districts tend to nominate the most liberal Democrat. The safe Republican district tends to nominate the most conservative Republican. And as you get more and more of those, you get more and more space and fewer and fewer people in.